Cisco was once the largest company on earth with a valuation of over $500 billion. So today I will tell you more about this company and if it is a good investment. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. I make one new video every day about the stock market, about investing and about entrepreneurship to help you become a better investor. Cisco pioneered the internet. Without Cisco, we would not have the internet like we have it today. What Cisco does is that they make the hardware necessary for connecting to the internet, necessary for the network itself to work. The WAN and the LAN, all these networks, most of them, they need Cisco technologies. And some of the products made by Cisco include the modems, routers, switches, all of these are made by Cisco. But nowadays, there are many companies making this, and one of which is gaining fame nowadays is Huawei. But Huawei has still problems to integrate in the Western world, so Cisco is still the leader in the Western world. Cisco was founded in 1984, and during the dot-com bubble, so many people were buying shares of Cisco that it became the largest company on earth. It attained a market capitalization of $500 billion, but then it crashed, and since then it did not gain this high price yet, so it's still below this all-time high. But right now, Cisco, in the last years, they have been growing a lot. And with 5G coming, there's one question we should be asking ourselves. Is Cisco going to win with 5G, and by how much? And it's not just about 5G. Cisco is entering into the Internet of Things, into cloud computing, into fog computing. All of this now is something that Cisco is working on. They are trying to improve the network. Cisco right now has five main business segments. The first one is infrastructure platform. This is 57% of revenues. So it is all the switch, the router, the data center that is provided by Cisco. The second one is application, that is 10% of revenue, and all of this is software related. 5% of revenue is from security, and 26% of revenue is from services. By services, it's all the technical support that they give to existing customers. Because now Cisco has grown so much, most people in the Western world already connected to the internet, they don't have a ground to further grow. Yes, they can grow in developing countries, but these developing countries, such as China, they already have Huawei. All of this, they already have a sort of company which will compete with Cisco. So in order for Cisco to continue to grow, they have to concentrate on services to give support to the existing customers so that the customers don't go to another competitor and they stay on the Cisco platform itself. 59% of the Cisco revenues come from the Americas, but they are well diversified. They have revenues from all over the world. And the main customers of Cisco today include businesses, industries, governments, internet service providers, and Now let's have a look at the fundamentals. They have a PE ratio of 19.44, a price per book of 5.78, a returns on asset of 7.19%, a returns on equity of 27.74%, a profit margin of 25.31%, a dividend yield of 2.48%, a debt to equity ratio of 0.62, and a current ratio of 1.80. If you will look at the income statement of Cisco for 2018, you will see something here, that there has been a very small net income compared to previous years. That doesn't mean that they have been losing money. The only thing that happened was that there was a huge tax payment. It was a 99.2% tax payment on their income tax. So they had a lot of money overseas, and to bring the money to the United States, they had to pay a huge tax on this. It was only one time. So in order for us to better analyze this company, I think we can ignore that high tax. And it's not only for Cisco, for many companies, you will see that there are these discrepancies because of the new tax laws. For example, even for Google, there was the same thing. They had so much money overseas that they had to bring to the United States, and they had to pay a huge tax on this. And with Berkshire Hathaway, the opposite happened. They had the money coming in from taxes, so they were reimbursed by the government. And for Amazon, they did not even pay federal income taxes in 2008. Of course, for you to better understand all of this, you have to look at each one of these companies individually to understand their tax situation and why they are paying more taxes or less taxes. And on average, for the coming 5 years, we can say taxes for businesses will be lower than usual, because now the federal corporate tax is 21% compared to 35%, which it was before Donald Trump became the president. Now, what about 5G? How 5G is going to affect the business of Cisco? I've been looking for 5G stocks in the recent month, but the problem with Cisco is that they have such a huge business. Even if they are going to include 5G into it, it won't make such a huge difference. If you're looking for a company which is going to win a lot by 5G, you have to understand that for a company making about $10 billion per year, now in order for them to include 5G, of course this will increase the earnings, but not by that much. And they're already having shares repurchased, they're already paying dividends. So this is not a company which is going to win a lot percentage-wise from 5G. But it is a great company. Unfortunately, at the current price, I don't think it is a good investment, but I'm looking at the company, I like it. So let me know in the comments, what do you think about Cisco? Thank you for watching this video. Please like, subscribe and share. Subscribe for one new video every day about the stock market, about investing and about entrepreneurship to help you become a better investor. Have a nice day and goodbye.